الطريق وطلبت الطريق الموصل إليه وقمت بطاعته على الوجه الأكمل، وإذا عظمت خفت منه، كلما هممت بمعصية استشعرت عظمة الخالق عز وجل فنفرت، ولقد همت به وهم بها لولا أن رأى برهان ربه، كذلك لنصرف عنه السوء والفحشاء. فهذه من نعمة الله عليك، فإذا هممت بمعصية وجدت الله أمامك فهبت وخفت وتبعدت عن المعصية لأنك تعبد الله رغبة ورهبة. معلش I'm speaking too much in Arabic but there's no problem. He says if you love Allah Azza wa Jal, you will be seeking that which is with Him, and you will seek the ways that will lead you to Him, and you will search for the path that will make you travel towards Him, and you will worship Him in the best way possible. You will do the act of worship in the waqf salam in the best way possible. Whereas, and if you magnify Allah, you understand what magnify is. يعني if to make, يعني you be in awe, awe. You are in awe from the majesty of Allah. It's based on how great Allah is. Due to the greatness, it causes effect on you. The greater the Allah, because of His greatness, it makes you recognize that greatness. So you magnify Allah based on His greatness, which make you fear Allah. Because if Allah wills, He will make the earth swallow us. If Allah wills, He will make the skies send upon us stones. He will send birds like He did upon the people of the field, the elephant. If Allah wills, He will make the water swallow us. Nobody has nothing. No power, man. Absolutely no power. By the mercy of Allah, nothing happens to us. By the mercy of Allah, we're alive. By the mercy of Allah, we're in a bounty. By the mercy of Allah, we're doing this. So you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Shaykh said, and if you fear Allah, if you magnify Allah, you will fear Him. Every time you're about to disobey, every time you're about to approach the sin, you bring to your heart, you recognize the greatness of Allah Azza wa Jal, the greatness of the Creator Azza wa Jal, so you run away from it. And Allah struck the example of, and the Shaykh mentioned the verse in the Quran where Allah told us about the story of Joseph, Yusuf alayhi salam. وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا. And she had the intention to do whatever she wanted with him, and he had a similar intention. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, until he seen the proof of his Lord, and Allah saved him from this evil path. Right? So when Yusuf alayhi salam recognized in his heart the greatness of Allah, and that Allah is looking upon him, although he's a man and the desires come in effect, he held back for the sake of Allah. And you know the narrations from the Prophet ﷺ which proves this particular verse about the three who went into a cave, and that Allah decreed that a stone closed the cave. Among them is a man who liked his cousin. And anyways, I will not discuss this right now because we have some youngsters with us, but you know what I'm saying. فَهَذِهِ مِن نِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكِ. He said, verily this is from the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you, that if you are about to commit a sin, if you are about to commit a sin, you will bring to mind that Allah Azza wa Jal, and that He is looking upon you. So you hold back, and you are shy, and you have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you leave alone the sin. So you worship Allah according to loving Him and fearing Him. And يعني, an example, you're driving down a car, and you see a woman who's not dressed properly. And nowadays they're all over the place. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from them by guiding them to the true proper dress code. But anyways, so the shaitan wants you to look. And a man can easily look. And this is a sign of heedlessness. Because Allah commanded us to lower our gaze. وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. Tell the believing men to lower their gaze. You don't be looking at something that is not lawful for you. Now, if you're not thinking about Allah Azza wa Jal, it's easy. You can keep looking. But if you start to look, and then you recognize and you remember that Allah is looking at you, you will feel shy. You will feel shy to see Allah, seeing Allah gave you this bounty, this blessing of the sight, while others are blind, while others are unable to use it. Maybe they need, so thick glasses, very thick glasses that they cannot live without them. And Allah bless you with proper sight. I'm not trying to pick on the brothers with the glasses, you know what I'm saying? I just seen it later. I was going to say the example. I was like, oh, we have two brothers with glasses, three of them actually. Four, but he put them away. Good one. That's a good one, Sheikh. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about the old school glasses, man. The one that is that thick. يعني a person really, if they take them off, خلاص. Anyways, Allah blesses you, even if you wear glasses, somebody's blind. Allah blesses with the sight. How do we get the ni'mah and use it to disobey the one who gave us the ni'mah? Yani it's difficult. We are weak. That's why we will still fall into this particular sin, but then we repent to Allah. But if we thought properly, we will have much less sin. I'm not saying you're going to become a perfect human being, you could never sin because you're always mindful of Allah. Yani if we do this, then we will be like the angels. And that's impossible for the son of Adam. So we will not reach the state, but we will be much lesser. We will have much lesser sins. If every time we're about to do a sin, we will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He's watching us. And so this is what ibadah is. فما معنى العباده؟ العباده worship تطلق على امرين على الفعل والمفعول. Ibadah is a title for two things. الفعل, the action, والمفعول, that which is being done. The act of worship and what is being done being called the worship. We will elaborate on what is intended by the وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله. تطلق على الفعل الذي هو التعبد فيقال عبد الرجل ربه عبادة وتعبدا. It is given as a title for the actual worship or the action. So you say the person عبد الرجل. This is a verb here, past tense. The person worshipped his Lord. The man worshipped his Lord, and then تعبدًا, worship in the sense of worship. This is very difficult to translate from Arabic to English, by the way, because of the various difference between the two languages and the lack of English terminology to meet with the Arabic terminology. So please forgive me if the message doesn't come across. Anyways, وإطلاقه على التعبد من باب إطلاق اسم المصدر على المصدر. وتعرفها باعتبار إطلاقها على الفعل بأنها تذل الله عز وجل حبا وتعظيما بفعل أوامره واجتناب نواهيه. وكل من ذل لله عز بالله ولله العزة ولرسوله. سورة المنافقون. طيب, the Sheikh says, and anyways, worship is humiliating oneself for the sake of Allah. When you worship Allah, this is humiliating yourself for the sake of Allah. Yani, the face right now is the most honorable part of the body, right? This is where we think, this is where we see, it's on top, the way Allah has proportioned the son of Adam versus the animal. You find the animal, the cow, the head and the behind are within a line, within the same, height. The man, son of Adam, as Allah says, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيلٍ. We have created the son of Adam in the best form. We are proportioned where the head is on top. And the head is the most honorable part of the body. The most honorable limb is the head. Yet in sujood, we go down on the ground. You may be in a masjid, you may be in the street, where the earth is not, the surface of the earth may not be a carpet. But it cannot be in najasa, it cannot be impurity, filth and garbage, but it may be some dust on the ground. But you still put your head, the most honorable part of your body, on the face down, for the sake of, only for Allah. If anybody told you to prostrate to a human being, you would refuse. So no matter who he is, who are you? You would reject to go down and humiliate yourself to this extent for a human being. But we do it with no problem for Allah Azza wa Jal. Actually, those who do the proper salah, and now we fluctuate here. Let's be honest with you. The way we do salah, there's a difference between the heavens and the earth between individuals in terms of how we feel the salah. So there are some people who are actually mindful of the salah. They know what they're saying, what they're doing. They know how to magnify Allah in their salah. So when it's time for sujood, their heart tremble. They're excited. They want to go down on the ground. You reach a point where you just want to go down on the ground and you want to ask Allah, you want to magnify Allah, you want to glorify Allah in the sujood. If you bring this to mind, it will help you understand how we want to humiliate ourselves for the sake of Allah. Now somebody will say, this is when the disbelievers will say, why? Why does God want, they always say, why does God, by the way, as if they